What's wrong with evolution? 10 most intriguing contradictions. Evolution is a key biological theory explaining species change through natural selection and genetic variation. While supported by extensive evidence, some aspects continue to puzzle scientists and spark lively debates. These contradictions challenge our understanding and keep the study of evolution a fascinating field. Here are 10 of the most intriguing contradictions that fuel discussions. Number 1. The existence of vestigial organs. Vestigial organs are body structures that appear to serve no current function but were likely essential for ancestors. In humans, the appendix, wisdom teeth, and tailbone are prime examples. Evolution is known to favor the elimination of unnecessary traits to conserve energy and resources, so why do these structures persist? The appendix, once considered a useless organ, may actually play a role in the immune system by acting as a reservoir for beneficial gut bacteria. This could help repopulate the intestines after illness, but the fact that people can live perfectly healthy lives without an appendix raises questions about its overall importance. Wisdom teeth, another example, were crucial for our ancestors who had larger jaws to accommodate more teeth for chewing tough food. Today, with smaller jaws and softer diets, wisdom teeth often cause overcrowding and must be removed. Number 2. Convergent evolution, similar solutions, different paths. Convergent evolution is the process where unrelated species independently evolve similar traits, adapting to similar environments or challenges. This phenomenon demonstrates that evolution does not always lead species down unique paths. Instead, similar selective pressures can produce comparable features in different species. A classic example is dolphins and sharks. Though dolphins are mammals and sharks are fish, both have developed streamlined bodies and fins for efficient swimming. Another example is bats and birds, both of which evolved wings despite belonging to entirely different classes of animals. Similarly, the marsupial sugar glider in Australia and the placental flying squirrel in North America both evolved skin flaps that allow them to glide, even though their evolutionary lineages are vastly different. These similarities are not the result of shared ancestry but arise from the species' need to survive in similar ecological niches. Convergent evolution shows that natural selection can lead to similar adaptations in species that face comparable challenges, complicating the evolutionary tree and reminding us that physical similarities do not always indicate close genetic relationships. Number 3. The persistence of genetic junk. In the human genome, a large percentage of DNA does not code for proteins, leading scientists to label it junk DNA for many years. According to evolutionary theory, unnecessary genetic material should disappear over time, as maintaining it comes at an energy cost. However, much of this non-coding DNA has persisted, raising questions about its purpose. Recent research has begun to uncover critical roles for non-coding DNA. For example, regulatory elements like promoters, enhancers, and non-coding RNAs play key roles in gene expression and chromosome structuring. Transposable elements, which move within the genome, may cause mutations but also contribute to genetic diversity, accelerating evolution by creating new gene combinations. The persistence of non-coding DNA challenges the outdated idea that it is simply junk and highlights the complexity of the genome. As scientists uncover new functions, they reshape our understanding of how genes operate and evolve, emphasizing that what was once considered useless may, in fact, be essential. Number 4. The human brain's energy consumption. The human brain is a remarkable organ, consuming about 20% of the body's total energy despite accounting for only about 2% of body weight. From an evolutionary perspective, maintaining such an energy-hungry organ would seem disadvantageous, unless the benefits outweighed the costs. The evolution of the human brain, with its large size and cognitive abilities, raises questions about the environmental pressures that favored this development. One leading hypothesis, the expensive tissue hypothesis, suggests that as humans began cooking food and adopting higher quality diets, their digestive systems required less energy. This shift freed up energy to be allocated to the brain. Another explanation is that complex social interactions, language, and problem-solving challenges in early human societies drove the need for increased brain power. While the brain's energy demands can make it vulnerable to nutritional deficiencies, The evolutionary advantages of enhanced cognition, such as improved tool use, communication, and cooperation, proved to be worth the metabolic cost. This balance between energy expenditure and survival benefits underscores how natural selection favors traits that enhance overall fitness, even if they come with significant trade-offs. Number 5. The missing link, gaps in human evolution. Humans and modern apes share a common ancestor, but the fossil record still contains significant gaps that make it difficult to fully trace our evolutionary journey. The term missing link refers to transitional fossils that would help bridge these gaps and demonstrate how modern humans evolved from ape-like ancestors. While key fossils like Australopithecus afarensis, known as Lucy, and Homo habilis have been discovered, the fossil record remains incomplete due to the rarity of fossilization and the likelihood that many fossils have been destroyed or remain undiscovered. This scarcity has led to debates about how and when critical human traits, such as bipedalism, tool use, and language, emerged. These gaps in the fossil record continue to challenge scientists as they work to piece together the story of human evolution. However, advances in genetics, including the analysis of ancient DNA, are beginning to fill in some of these missing links. Though the fossil record is incomplete, it continues to offer valuable insights into our evolutionary past. Number 6. The rapid rise of human civilization. Modern Homo sapiens have existed for around 200,000 to 300,000 years, but the most significant advancements in human civilization, such as agriculture, writing, and urbanization, only began about 12,000 years ago with the Neolithic Revolution. This relatively short period of time saw the rise of complex societies, monumental architecture, and technological innovations that dramatically transformed the way humans live. This rapid progress raises questions about why human civilization remained relatively static for so long and then suddenly accelerated. One theory suggests that the end of the last ice age brought about stable climate conditions, allowing agriculture to thrive. Another theory posits that population growth reached a tipping point, forcing early humans to develop new methods for food production and social organization. Genetic changes may have also played a role, enhancing human cognitive abilities and enabling the development of language, social complexity, and technological innovation. This combination of biological and cultural evolution allowed humans to build upon the achievements of previous generations, accelerating the pace of progress. The rapid rise of civilization underscores the interplay between evolutionary biology and cultural evolution, with each influencing the other in ways that shape the course of human history. Number 7. The Peacock's Tale, Beauty Over Survival. The male peacock's extravagant tail is one of nature's most striking examples of sexual selection. Large, colorful, and adorned with eye-catching patterns, the tail helps attract females, but it comes at a cost. It's heavy, cumbersome, and makes it harder for peacocks to escape predators. Despite these drawbacks, the peacock's tail persists due to its role in reproduction. Female peahens are drawn to males with the most impressive displays, seeing the tail as an indicator of good genes and fitness. The reproductive advantage outweighs the survival risks, showing that evolution sometimes prioritizes traits that enhance mating success, even if they make survival more difficult. Number 8. Altruism in the animal kingdom. Altruism, where an individual helps others at a personal cost, is common in the animal world. Meerkats risk their lives by standing guard to alert others of predators, and vampire bats share blood with less fortunate members of their group. This behavior seems contradictory to the survival of the fittest principle. Kin selection offers one explanation: helping relatives increases the survival chances of shared genes. For instance, a meerkat protecting its group is also safeguarding its own genetic legacy. Reciprocal altruism explains acts among unrelated individuals, where animals help others with the expectation of future benefits. These behaviors challenge the idea that evolution strictly favors individual survival and suggest that helping the group can be an advantageous strategy. Number 9. Rapid evolutionary changes. Evolution is typically thought of as a slow process, but in some cases, significant changes can happen rapidly, even within a few generations. One of the best-known examples is the rise of antibiotic resistance in bacteria. When exposed to antibiotics, most bacteria are killed, but a few resistant individuals survive and pass their resistance genes to offspring. This can lead to widespread resistance in a short time, making certain antibiotics ineffective. Similarly, insects have developed resistance to pesticides, and plants have evolved tolerance to herbicides. These examples highlight that evolution can happen quickly when selective pressures are strong, challenging the traditional view that evolution is always gradual. Number 10. The irreducible complexity of certain biological structures. Some biological systems are so complex that it seems all their parts must be present for them to function, raising the idea of irreducible complexity. The bacterial flagellum, a microscopic motor that propels bacteria, is often cited as an example. Removing even one part makes it non-functional, posing a challenge to the theory of gradual evolution. However, scientists have proposed that existing structures may have been repurposed for new functions. For example, parts of the flagellum might have originally served other roles, like protein secretion, before being adapted for movement. This idea, called exaptation, helps explain how complex systems could evolve over time, even if they seem too intricate to develop in a step-by-step manner.